Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at using images in Pages. So I'm using Pages version 5 here, and we're going to look at using images inside documents. So I've created a regular document here. I'm going to show the layout so we can see some of the elements. And let's add some text first and then an image. So here's some random text. Now let's click on the Media button here to add an image. And I'm going to just grab something from my Photos library. I could also drag and drop from the Finder right into Pages. I don't need to use this Media button if I don't want to. So let's grab an image, and it's going to insert it here and basically have it fill the width of the page. I'm going to grab one of the corner handles there and shrink it down. You can see that it shrinks and the text wraps around it very nicely. So I can put it here inside my text. As long as I have it on the right side, text will wrap on the left. And if I move it over here, it's going to wrap on the right. Put it in the middle, and it's just going to skip the image. So let's position it nicely right there and then start to manipulate it. So first let's bring up the format sidebar here by clicking on format, and we could see that we've got the image there. Since it's what's selected, it's going to show us that. And we've got some styles here that we could use, like we could put a nice frame around it like this or like that or anything we want. So there's a lot of different styles that we can do, and then we can customize them further down here. So you could see you could customize the type of border, choose one of the picture frames, and there's a lot of them, or you could go with a line and then choose the size of the line and the color. You could also do some special effects, like having a drop shadow underneath it, and there's a whole bunch of different other types of shadows you can add, and you can add a reflection underneath too. You can also make the image semi-transparent if you want. In addition, you can go to Image here, and there's a bunch of different things you can do. There's a Replace button, which is kind of nice. You could also edit the mask here, which what that allows you to do is basically crop the photo. So if there's something you wanted to center in on, you could do that, hit Done, and you could see you're just showing that part of the image. You can, while you're cropping it, you could also reposition inside. So there's a lot you could do with that. You can also adjust the image, for instance, just some basic photo filters to make it look better without having to go back to the original image. There's an automatic enhance button. There's a whole panel here where there's a ton of controls and things that you can do. And lastly, we could arrange things here. So we can actually set how the text wraps. So we saw it was doing it automatic depending upon the placement. We could set it to some sort of permanent type of wrapping here, so we can have it go around on both sides. Probably isn't a good idea in this case. There's a bunch of different things you can do. You can also have it do none, which means it floats on top of what's there. And that's where being semi-transparent might be interesting. You can arrange things. If you have more than one image, you can decide which one's in front, which one's behind. So like for instance here, I can do arrange and send this one to the back or move it to the front. You also can manually adjust the size of the image here, setting exact amount if you want. You can also manually adjust the position. And here's where you can also rotate the image, right like that. And you can see the text fit is set up here to wrap around the exact image here. I could set it to create a rectangular area instead and adjust the amount of spacing as well. And you could do things like flipping the image also. By the way, another way to do rotation is instead of dragging one of these handles like this, you hold a Command key down when you're over one of these handles and see how it changes to a rotation thing there. And you can rotate it like that. So you don't have to use this to exactly set the rotation.